Bible reading. Reading from the Holy Bible, Psalm chapter 105, verses 1 to 4.
Give thanks to the Lord. Call on his name. Make them known among the nation what he has done. Sing to him, sing praise to him, tell of all his wonderful act. Glory in his holy name. Let the heart of those who seek the Lord rejoice. Look to the Lord and his tent, seek his face always. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Prayer. Almighty loving Heavenly Father, Creator of heaven and earth, thank you for all the blessings you have bestowed upon us. We are truly grateful for them. Thank you for allowing us today to meet and share our knowledge and time with one another in this association meeting. May you extend your divine wisdom to our speaker so that she could be able to impact effectively her God-given knowledge to all of us. May she be blessed as she continues to bring her expertise to people who need them. Bless the participant as well so that they could able to be glean the virtual information from this activity. May you bestow your blessings after this meeting so that we may go out and spread what we learn in a spirit of your love and generosity. May we realize that this activity should glorify your name. Amen.
Thank you, girls, for helping us to feel the presence of God. Every thought you produce, anything you say, any action you do, it bears your signature. If the sign on your heart says welcome, the love will come pouring in from everywhere. Now, I invite Shalini from 3rd BSc Physics B to welcome the online gathering.
To one and all gather here, I extend my very sincere and warm welcome to all of you present here. First and foremost, I would like to extend my warm gratitude to all for giving me this beautiful opportunity to welcome you all. I extend my hearty welcome to our ever supporting secretary, respected principal, and vice principal for their blessings and guidance. I deem it a great privilege in welcoming our chief guest, Dr. A. Nancy Anna Anastasia, Research Associate of Indira Gandhi Center for Atomic Research, Kalpakkam, who's going to spend her golden time with us today.
Thank you.
Her area of research includes synthesis and deposition of metal and metal oxide, nanostructures for the detection of toxic, flammable, and explosive gases or vapor, electrode and heater development for sensing elements using screen printing, computational studies on gas-solid interaction using density function theory. She has authored and co-authored many articles and has also published many papers in reputed journals. Dr. Nancy is the proud recipient of following awards: Award of Fellowship as Research Associate in Indira Gandhi Center for Atomic Research, Junior Research Fellow in Defense Research and Developmental Organization, and also won Best Poster Award in International Conference on Frontiers in Nanoscience and Nanotechnology. Such an accomplished speaker is now with us today. We welcome you, ma'am.
Thank you.
A genial welcome to our dynamic HOD, Dr. Inigo Mary Rita. I cordially welcome our association secretaries, Ms. Jasmine Banu, Ms. Babiana, Ms. Jayalakshmi, and our beloved teacher for their motivation and guidance. Last but not the least, I would like to welcome all our budding future physicists of our nation. I once again welcome you all. Thank you.
Thank you, Shalini, for your sweet words of welcome address. If you read just 15 minutes a day, in 1 year, you will have read more than 10 lakh words. Now we have minutes reading.
Hello. toilets retained. The webinar on menstrual cycle and hygiene management was organized by PG Research Department of Physics, Holy Cross College Autonomous, Tiruchirappalli on December 7, 2020 through Booming Platform. The resource person was Dr. V. Vijay, MBBS, DCO. The speaker started her presentation by highlighting the different stages involved in a female reproductive life cycle from puberty to menopause. She discussed about the different phases in a menstrual cycle and also recommended students to make their period diary so that it would be helpful to analyze the regularity of periods. Dr. V. Vijay insisted about the proper usage of napkins and cloth and the importance of disposing it in a proper manner. She described about the struggles that each female undergoes during her menstrual cycle and the ways to tackle it. At last, she ended up the session by giving a detailed explanation about polycystic ovary syndrome. More than 252 students and 18 staff participated with great enthusiasm and interacted with the speaker and clarified their doubts. Great conjunction of Jupiter and Saturn. PG and Research Department of Physics in association with Vignan Prachar, DST, TNSTC, Arivial Palagai, Trichy Astro Club, Physics Departments of Vishwamitra College, Trichy, National College, Trichy, Jamal Bowman College, Trichy, and Nehru Memorial College, Pudanapatti organized a Zoom online live program. Reading. The webinar on menstrual cycle and hygiene management was organized by PG and Research Department of Physics, Holy Cross College Autonomous, Tiruchirappalli on December 7, 2020 through Google Meet platform. The resource person was Dr. V. Vijay, MBBS, DCO. The speaker started her presentation by highlighting the different stages involved in a female reproductive life cycle from puberty to menopause. She discussed about the different phases in a menstrual cycle and also recommended the students to make their period diary so that it would be helpful to analyze the regularity of periods. Dr. V. Vijay insisted about the proper usage of napkins and cloth and the importance of disposing it in a proper manner. She described about the struggles that each female undergoes during her menstrual cycle and the ways to tackle it. At last, she ended up the session by giving a detailed explanation about polycystic ovary syndrome. More than 252 students and 18 staff participated with great enthusiasm and interacted with the speaker and clarified their doubts. Great conjunction of Jupiter and Saturn. PG and Research Department of Physics in association with Physics Departments of Vishwamitra College, Trichy, National College, Trichy, Jamal Bowman College, Trichy, and Nehru Memorial College, Pudanapatti organized a Zoom online live program of Great Conjunction of Jupiter and Saturn on 20th December 2020 at 6:30 p.m. More than 252 students and 18 staff attended the program through Zoom platform and YouTube. Alumni Meet. The PG and Research Department of Physics, Holy Cross College, Tiruchirappalli arranged the departmental alumni meet in the name of Homecoming 2021 on 9 January 2021 through Google Meet platform. The alumni meet began with the prayer and the welcome address was delivered by Dr. A. Nigomeri Rita, Head Department of Physics. A senior staff member of Physics Department, Mrs. J. Malathi, rendered an inspirational talk to the participants. 116 participants have registered for the alumni meet, out of which 69 participants attended this meet. Alumni from various batches met all the staff members online and shared their experiences and thanked them for their kind support and encouragement throughout their course. Alumni details were collected through Google Form. The innovative and interesting games were conducted for the participants. Dr. A. Philomenil, Assistant Professor, Department of Physics, proposed the word of thanks.
Thank you, Raghavi, for recollecting the information through video recording. Time has come to grasp some information. Here, desire like the atom is explosive with creative force. Yes, desire like the atom, we are waiting for your explosive speech. It's my pleasure to invite Dr. A. Nancy Ma'am, an alumni of our Holy Cross College, to enlighten us on the topic, Emerging Trends in Research.
Thank you. First of all, I would like to thank Holy Cross for inviting me, and especially this physics department. And as you know, the topic is emerging and recent trends in research. Can you be able to see myself? Hello. Hello.
No, ma'am. We can't able to see your screen.
I'm not getting sharing option.
Yes, ma'am.
Share is not available. Can someone? Okay, hope you can see now.
Yes, ma'am. Now it is visible.
Okay. Okay, good evening, everyone. I'm Nancy Alana Sasia, working as a research associate in Novel Chemical Sensor Section, IGCAR, Karpak. Today's presentation concentrated on emerging and recent trends in research. Outline of today's presentation is we're going to see about what is research or definition of research. After that, we're going to see about the recent trends in research. In that, we are going to focus about nanomaterials and the way to synthesize coating and deposition of nanomaterials and available characterization tools. Finally, we're going to see about some of the application of nanomaterials. And in the my area of research is chemistry and sensor. And finally, we're going to see about the job opening of research. If you type in Google, define research means, you can get this statement, right? It is like a creative and systematic work undertaken to increase your knowledge. But my way of defining research is, you should have a solid question or need or problem. Based on that solid question, you have to start your literature survey. Literature survey is nothing but background research is needed. Make sure that it is testable. And also, you should be work hard enough and smart thinking is needed to achieve the success. The recent trend in research is for biological application. The biological people is working in cancer, tissue engineering, virology, and genetic engineering. For computer science, EEE, ECE, and mathematics students working in developing softwares, artificial intelligence, and machine learning. For chemistry people, physics and materials people, they mostly concentrate on nanomaterials because they are having wide range of applications. Also, some chemists and material sciences working phase diagram and instrumental development and research. Also, one of the emerging trend is computational studies. These people having tremendous contributions in biology, chemistry, physics and mechanical studies. As a physics person, you can concentrate on these two areas. My area of interest is nanomaterials. If you talk about nanomaterials, the size of the object in the scale of 1 to 100 nanometer, at least in one dimension. Actually, we are a human, we are in meter range. My area of interest is 1 nanometer to 100 nanometers. Why this sizes need to be decreased? Means it have an advantage. What is it having higher surface to volume ratio? Hence, one can expect higher surface energy and quantum confinement. What is surface to volume ratio means? I have taken one rectangle. Let us we assume this is 1 centimeter side. This is also 1 centimeter, and let us assume this is a 4 centimeter. It will occupy the same size, right? 1 cross 1 cross 4. If I reduce the size of rectangle, that same volume I can fit 2. If you still reduce infinite number of rectangle, I can fit. So once I decrease the size of that material, I can fit accommodate more. So surface to volume ratio of the material can increase, and higher it will lead to higher surface energy. Higher surface energy facilitate it is important for more applications. And I talked about quantum confinement, which we're going to discuss in the forthcoming slides. Once you talk about nanomaterials, actually you have to, it will be related to quantum mechanics, because there we are discussing energy as a discrete. The basic difference between classical and quantum mechanics, whereas classical, we are considering energy as continuous, whereas in quantum mechanics, the energy is decreased, that is quantized, discrete, that is quantized. This is a simple example of bulk, and that is three-dimensional structure. Just we assume a sea. We have a plenty of fish. That fish can move in all the directions, like X, Y, and Z. There is no confinement or no restriction, in other words. Let me assume a swimming pool having enough length and enough width. But the depth of the swimming pool is let me assure you, depth of the swimming pool is equal to the size of fish. If the fish cannot move along the depth, right? So confinement in one direction, but the fish can move in two dimensions, length as well as width. Depth only getting confined. I am going to put the fish in a water pipe. So whereas that width and depth is confined, but the fish only travel along the tube only. So length is it can move. That is for one dimensional structure. If it is zero dimensional structure, it is confined in all the direction. If I choose the bowl of same size of fish, okay. As a summary, we are having four different things. One is bulk. All this, the size of the bulk is greater than 100 nanometer. So no restriction, degrees of freedom is 3. If you see about 10 plan, that thickness will be in nanometer range. So confinement in one direction, degrees of freedom is two dimension. If you talk about wire, that is our tube, like a water pipe, no? So it will having a dimension in X and Y, that is two dimensional in nanoscale, confinement in two dimensional, and degrees of freedom in. If you take a quantum bowl, that bowl, it's confined in all direction. So restriction or confinement in three direction and degrees of freedom is zero. I'm replacing that sea with material. I'm replacing that fish with electron. So as a bulk, it can move wherever it wants. When it will go to two-dimensional structure, the thickness is less than 100 nanometer. So example, so it cannot move along the thickness. So example is nanocoating, nanofilms, and thin films. One-dimensional structure is, example is nanowires, nanorods, and nanotube. The difference between nanowires and nanorods is only aspect ratio. Length to width ratio will be greater greater for a wire, it will be lesser for a rod. Tube means it will be hollow structure, whereas rod means it's still one. Tube means like cylinder one. And this is the corresponding example. And zero dimensional structure is quantum dot or nanoparticle. We should have a size less than 100 nanometer in all the dimensions. Okay, fine. What will be that energy state? That is density of state, number of energy level per unit volume per unit energy. For a bulk, it will be like that. Since it is confined in one direction, it will be like it will offer you a step-like behavior for two-dimensional films. If you go for one-dimensional material, it will be like a spike. Since it is confined in two directions, if it is a quantum dot, it confined in three directions, it will offer you one line. Okay, fine. Actually, what is happening in the domain of quantum confinement? Like we know, right? Mean free paths are average distance between two scattering events. That is called mean free path. I am assuming that is one. I am going to make a device. The size is greater than one means the electron undergo many scattering. Okay, here one scattering, here it is scattering due to boundary, again here it is scattering due to another event because that size is greater than one, greater than its mean free path. If I am reducing the size of the conductor less than one nanometer, means electron travel without any scattering, but it will have a scattering only at the boundaries. So this is the major advantage why we are going to nanomaterials. And this is the same image of nanomaterial. This is quantum dot, that is zero dimensional material. Actually, this is a TEM image. This is one dimensional material. This is rod. Here it is filled in a, whereas if it is a tube, it is not filled. And if the diameter also high, that's why I named this a rod. Otherwise, if the diameter is less, it will go to nanowires. And this is the nano sheets, example for two dimensional structures. And how to synthesize coating and deposition of nanomaterial. Actually, I didn't write a single word, right? Here I mentioned synthesize, coating, and deposition because each term having different meaning. Synthesize will offer you in the form of generally powder. Coating means you need a substrate. Okay, if the difference between coating and deposition is the adhesiveness. The stickiness between the material and substrate will be less in coating. It will be good in deposition. Okay. These are the general method or widely used method for the synthesis of nanomaterials: sorgel for precipitation, hydrothermal, solid state reaction, and combustion method. This will offer you the form of powder. Okay, these are the that is zinc coating to deep coating, till that it is covering under coating. Okay, these are the area where I am working actually. Thin film deposition technique. Actually, thin film deposition technique classified into three: under liquid phase, vapor phase, and physical deposition. We know physical deposition means we can evaporate the material. Sputtering means we have to create plasma. Pulse laser deposition is we are using a laser to create flows. Whereas the difference between plasma is it is fourth state of matter. There is, you cannot find any neutral atom in if you created a plasma. If it is flume means it will consist whatever it was actually. It may having ions, it may having neutral atom, it may having small particles also. So that is we called it as flume. And vapor phase deposition is we are having vapor. You are creating vapor. That vapor is contains on a substrate. Actually, these two techniques require high wafer and good targets to achieve a high quality films. But the quality of the films is very good if you are going for physical and vapor phase deposition. But in liquid, compare the liquid phase deposition. If you see about liquid phase deposition, it is the cheapest method. It's not even required vacuum. It's not even required a high-power instruments. It will record only chemicals and a few gases. That's it. And for electrochemical deposition means that is electrically driven the chemical reaction. That is electrochemical deposition. And hydrothermal means we are using the temperature pressure during the reaction. Basically, the used solvent is water. And in chemical bulk deposition, we simply using both the precursor and by heating or keeping for a long time, we can get the product. Spray pyrolysis means we are creating the aerosols. That aerosol getting thermally decomposed on a substrate to form a film. Successive ionic layer adsorption reaction method means we are having three separate containers. One will have a cationic, and then rinsing, an anionic solution, and final rinsing. Then fourth rinsing gives you a film. This is an overview of synthesis, coating, and deposition of cellulose. Okay, I did this. What I should do? Then you have to characterize film to confirm whether it is formed or not, in what state it is there. Okay. First is physics things. One is powder or greasing or glancing in incident exergy to confirm the crystalline nature of the material. And we are going for FSM microscopy, field scanning electron microscopy, or FE. FE is stand for field emission. It will give you a better resolution than normal thermionic emission bath. It will give you the morphology of your film. And energy dispersive X-ray spectroscopy and elemental mapping will give you the presence of element. Transmission electron microscopy, from that we can measure actual size and shape and also despacing of the particle. And XPS, that is X-ray photo electron spectroscopy, tell you the oxidation state of each element. For example, I'm going to deposit a zinc oxide material. Whether zinc in which oxidation state, 2+ state or what oxidation, whether oxygen in the ring 2+ state or some other, that you can confirm using XPS. Raman spectroscopy, it will give you structure as well as purity of the material. For example, most of the people are working in graphene and graphene oxide material. But actually, you cannot distinguish graphene and graphene oxide using X-ray. But Raman will tell you whether it is a graphene or graphene oxide material. And UV visible spectroscopy is for optical and band gap measurement. Atomic force microscopy for topographical analysis. FTR, that is Fourier's transform infrared spectroscopy for functional elemental analysis. Hall measurement for carrier concentration and mobility. Thickness propellant meter for measuring thickness of thin film or thick films. Applications. Okay. The current hot topic is energy and transition nowadays. In energy, we are having solar cell. solar cell, they are built up to three generation. First one is silica based, second is thin film based, third one is actually they are having dissense rate, quantum dot, and thermosense. Solar cell is coming under third generation solar cell. And we are having a super capacitor and battery for storage purpose. Only the storing mechanism will be different for both. And if you talk about hydrogen, you know, it is a greener way of producing energy. We can produce the hydrogen or say hydrogen having good explosive limit. So for safety purpose, you can detect the hydrogen. You can also store the hydrogen. It is not a, hydrogen will be in a gas state, right? Storing also a big task. And hydrogen based fuel cell is the best topic because it will hydrogen and oxygen combined will produce only water, so it won't affect our environment. So hydrogen and energy is always a hot topic, so physics student can prepare both. And safety means they will using electrical based measure detection or optical or electrochemical and cantilever and acoustical sensor we are having to detect the toxic, harmful, hazardous gas, or the explosive or flammable gas. In some extent, you can get chemical warfare issues. And here, electrical means in the presence of that analyte gas or analyte beeper, your signal, electrical signal, get varied. Optical means generally it will vary the refracting gas changes. We can, from that, we can measure that conservation. And electrochemicals means we will like reduce that electrode. It will be mostly solution things like how much sugar is there, sugar content in that solution, like that biological condition generally they will use. And this is the cantilever means the frequency change of the cantilever in the presence of gas molecule used to detect the presence of gas. And acoustical sensors, at first, acoustical wave changes leads to detect the sensor performance. And photodetector, as you know, will detect that light or electromagnetic radiation that will convert that material, convert that for incident light intensity to electrical signal. And light emitting diodes, as you know, it is the reverse process. If it will like a PN junction, if that material, if you pass that electricity, it will produce that light. And catalyst, it is very wide area. That energy, hydrogen, catalyst is the evergreen things. So you can start working. At least it will live a minimum 50 years. So catalyst means they will having three type of catalyst. One is electrical based, another one is photon, and this photoelectronic catalyst. If it is, for what purpose it is using is for water treatment they are using, dye degeneration it is using, and there is a high pressure process. The material at high pressure, in what way it is behave, like that the study will go. And fluid dynamics for heat transfer, that is whether that nanoparticle is efficiently can transfer the heat like that density. Magnetic, as you know, right? Magnetic study, magnetic property of the material will study whether it is a hard magnet or soft magnet based on that, that application gets varies. And one of the topic is thin film and coating for corrosive wettability and anti-reflection studies. My area is something electrical based detection for safety purpose. Actually based in chemiresistance, that is in the presence of chemical environment, the resistance of the material will vary. So generally I am using metal oxide semiconductor or metal. Here I am producing, presenting the schematic diagram of metal oxide semiconductors reducing input. We know, right, metal oxide having one n-type and p-type. If it is an n-type, the majority carrier is electron. If it is p-type, the majority carrier is holes. If the material is exposed to air, the oxygen getting absorbed by trapping the electron from the conduction band. So obviously the resistance of the material getting increased. Once there the introducing the reducing vapor, the electron is giving back to the conduction of the material, the conduction band of the material, hence the resistance of the material decreased. So we can measure actually the concentration or the presence of target vapor. And here this is p-type material, the thing is reverse. Since the p-type material having majority carrier holes, once the oxygen drop the electron, the conductivity of the material getting increased, that is resistance of the material getting decreased. Once it is giving back the electron, the resistance material increase. As a semiconductor, we have n-type and p-type. For if you think about gas, we have oxidation and reducing gas. The corresponding resistance changes given in the form of table here. Okay, fine. Now we are talking about job opening in research. Can I join in a research institution using pulse standard qualification? Yes, you can join. The post is lab assistant or technician. What is the minimum qualification required? You should get a minimum 60 mark in your third standard. And if you apply for a physics job, you must study the max physics as a subject, chemistry as a subject. How much salary they can provide and what is the minimum limit? They can provide 21,700 plus government allowance. And age limit is 18 to 27. Just and giving that overview, it may vary based on the government norms. And can I join in a research institute after my BSc? Yes, you can join. You can join as a scientific assistant. Qualification is minimum 60 marks in your BSc. Salary you can expect 44,900 plus government allowance. Age limit is 18 to 30. Okay, I did it my on the BSc. May I join with my MSc qualification because I want to complete my master? You may ask that question. So yes, you can join. You can join as a scientific officer or technical officer or chair, that is junior research fellow, or project assistant, or you can register your higher studies. Qualification is minimum 60 marks in your MSc. Salary is, if you join as a scientific officer or technical officer, your salary is starting from 56,100 to 67,700 plus government allowance. Age limit is 26 years. If you want to join as a JRF in a government organization, you can get a stipend amount of 31,000. Age limit is 28. If you want to join as a project assistant for some other projects, or if you want to join as a PhD scholar in deemed university, you can get only 60,000. There is no age limit. So you should design your future. So okay, after completing my PhD, what should I do? Okay, you can join as a research associate, or you can join as a scientific officer, the grade is high. And also you can go out as a assistant professor in some other college or universities or IITs institutions. RA salary, research associate salaries will be around 50%. Okay, there may be people like me. I don't want to leave Tamil Nadu. I don't want to stay far away from any place. Did I get a research job in Tamil Nadu? Yes, you can get. Is it easy to get a job in research field? Yes, it is easy. Okay, what should I do to get a job? First, you have to have a desire. Then you have to search for that. Second, you have to study well with your understanding. Be patient and conscious. முதல்ல அந்த ஜாப் வேணுன்ற விருப்பம் இருக்கணும், அதை சார்ந்த ஒரு தேடல் இருக்கணும். பிசிக்ஸ்லாம் எடுத்துட்டா ஒரு 10 சப்டிவிஷனா வந்து நம்ம சப்ஜெக்ட் படிக்கலாம். மெக்கானிக்ஸே ஒரு 3 வந்துடும். ஸோ அதில் அந்த 10 படிக்கணுன்ற அவசியம் இல்லை. உங்க ஒரு இன்டர்வியூக்கு ப்ரிப்பேர் பண்ணுறீங்கன்னா, இல்லாட்டி ஒரு என்ட்ரன்ஸ் எக்ஸாம்க்கு ப்ரிப்பேர் பண்ணுறீங்கன்னா, அந்த என்ட்ரன்ஸ் எக்ஸாமில் எந்தெந்த ஃபீல்டை கவர் பண்ணுறாங்கன்றாங்க. ஸோ அது அந்த ஃபீல்டில் கொஞ்சம் தரவா இருங்க. இல்லாட்டி வந்து உங்களை இன்டர்வியூ பண்றப்போ டெல் வந்து ஒரு மூணு உங்களுக்கு பிடிச்ச சப்ஜெக்ட் சொல்லுவாங்க. ஸோ யூ ஷுட் பி தரவ் இன் ஆஃப் இன் த்ரீ சப்ஜெக்ட்ஸ். தட் இஸ் யூ மே குட் இன் மேத்தமேட்டிக்ஸ், மேத்தமேட்டிக்கல் பிசிக்ஸ், யூ மே குட் இன் குவாண்டம் மெக்கானிக்ஸ், யூ மே குட் இன் சால்வ் ஸ்டடிஸ். ஸோ யூ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஃபிக்ஸ் விச் சப்ஜெக்ட் யூ வாண்ட் டு ஸ்டடி அண்ட் பி பேஷண்ட், பிகாஸ் திஸ் அட்வர்டைஸ்மெண்ட் வில் கம் இயர்லி ஒன்ஸ் ஆர் ட்வைஸ். ஸோ பி பேஷண்ட் அண்ட் பி கான்ஃபிடன்ஸ் தட் யூ கேன் கெட் இட். And wish you all the best for your success in your life. Any questions? Hello?
Yes, Nancy, yes, ma'am.
Any questions?
girls, you have any questions, please ask. Girls, you have any questions? Please unmute your audio. You can ask questions directly, or otherwise you post it in the chat box. If there are no questions, can we move on to the vote of thanks? Infant?
Ma'am?
Yes, thank Infant, you, ma'am. You can go ahead.
Ma'am, yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. It was an excellent presentation to have the opportunity to hear your thoughts. And this is definitely encouraging us in our future events. The real gift of gratitude is that the more grateful you are, the more present you become. Now, I would like to call Harisha from 2nd BSc Physics B to deliver the vote of thanks.
Good evening, everyone. The roots of all goodness lie in the soil of appreciation. I deem it a great...
Thank you for all those who are invited.
Yes, thank Nancy, you, ma'am. You can feel the connect. Yeah, thank you, Nancy, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. May I leave the session?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much for coming, ma'am. We'll meet thank in you. The next association meeting if possible.
Sure, ma'am. Your invitations are always welcome.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Yeah. Girls, kindly fill up the attendance form without fail. Dear teachers, kindly fill up the form. The attendance link is posted in the chat box. Kindly fill up the form.
Thank you.
Jasmine and Jaya, thank you.
Baby ma'am and Jaya ma'am, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Jasmine.
Thank you, Jaya.
இன்னும் இருக்காங்களா போயிட்டாங்களா
இனிக்கோ மேம் தேங்க்யூ டியர் டீச்சர்ஸ் மேம் வீட்டில் இல்லை மேம்
இனிக்கோ மேம் இல்லை மேம்
Girls, fill up the form without fail.